Hello, visual learners. Today, we're going over everything you need to know about the antibiotic class fluoroquinolones using Memory Pharm's Top 200 Drugs Made Easy coloring book. So if you're ready, then grab your color pencils and let's color and learn. Fluoroquinolones are a broad-spectrum class of antibiotics that is widely used. Sometimes, it seems as though it's a little too popular considering the amount of bacterial resistance that's formed and side effects associated with it. Let's dive deeper to learn more. First, when you think of this class of fluoroquinolones, use the visual anchors of florals. Here's why. The drugs in this class are super easy to recognize as they all end in the suffix floxacin. So anything that ends in floxacin should remind you of the phlox flower, which is a type of floral for fluoroquinolones. This class of antibiotics is known to have a broad spectrum of activity, meaning they cover gram-positive, gram-negatives, and atypical bacteria, making them useful for many different types of bacterial infections, including respiratory infections, UTIs, bone and joint and soft tissue infections, traveler's diarrhea, and sexually transmitted diseases. Now let's take a minute to review a couple of coverage nuances that stand out that you will need to know for exams. If you're treating a UTI, do not use moxifloxacin, as it does not concentrate well in the urine, leading to ineffective treatment. It is the only fluoroquinolone with double X in its generic name to remind you that it should not be used for UTIs. Pop quiz, which antibiotics cover Pseudomonas, a resistant gram-negative bacteria? Think levofloxacin and ciprofloxacin. Here's a tip, levo and cipro rhyme with pseudo. Another thing to note is that moxifloxacin has great anaerobic coverage and the other fluoroquinolones do not. Some contraindications and precautions you need to know about this class. It should not be used in patients who are pregnant and children less than 18 years old due to the risk of arthropathy or joint disease. You want to be cautious in patients with renal impairment as these drugs require renal adjustments. The only exception is moxifloxacin, which doesn't have great concentration where again? Yes, you got it. It doesn't concentrate well in the urine, which is why it should not be used for UTIs. You also want to avoid fluoroquinolones in patients with tendon rupture and or inflammation and a history of myasthenia gravis due to the worsening of muscle weakness. You also want to be cautious in elderly patients as there's an increased risk of side effects. But how does this class work? Fluoroquinolones work by inhibiting DNA enzymes involved in bacterial DNA synthesis, which works to block DNA replication and leads to bacterial cell death. The two enzymes that are inhibited include DNA gyrase and topoisomerase 4, two essential enzymes in bacterial DNA transcription and replication. For side effects, think of the mnemonic, don't spring up too fast or you get tendril rupture. S is for skin rash and sun sensitivity. P is for prolongation of QTC interval and peripheral neuropathy. Definitely know this. R is for rupture of tendons. Fluoroquinolone labels already have a box warning for tendonitis, tendon rupture, and worsening of myasthenia gravis. I is for increased risk of C. difficile infection, like most antibiotics. N is for neurological, as this medication can cause confusion and insomnia, especially in elderly patients. G is for GI intolerance, including nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and dysglycemia, meaning hypo or hyperglycemia. As you could probably already see, fluoroquinolones have a lot of side effects associated with them. Because of this, the FDA placed a warning label saying that fluoroquinolones should only be reserved for treatment of bacterial infections where no other treatment options are available, or if it is considered a serious infection. Some counseling points to keep in mind. You want to take this medication with or without food and with a full glass of water. You want to give fluoroquinolones at least 2 hours before or 6 hours after divalent cations such as antacids, iron supplements, dairy products since they interfere with fluoroquinolone absorption. As with all antibiotics, it's important to complete the full course of therapy as prescribed even if symptoms resolve. Advise your patients to wear sunscreen to decrease sun sensitivity and sunburn. Alright, let's take a quick minute to review because repetition is the mother of all learning. When thinking about fluoroquinolones, think florals. Let's color in these flowers and their key points and their respective colors. For mechanism of action, let's color this in blue. Why? Well, we all remember that fluoroquinolones work to inhibit what kind of enzymes? Yes, DNA enzymes, and remember that DNA is the blueprint of life. Specifically, fluoroquinolones work to inhibit bacteria DNA synthesis by blocking which two enzymes? Yes, DNA gyrase and DNA topoisomerase 4. Moving on to key points. Let's color in this flower in purple. P for purple, like P for points, we need to remember. First, we want to avoid giving fluoroquinolones 2 hours before or 6 hours after. What kind of products? Yes, antacids, iron, and dairy products, because they contain divalent cations that interfere with fluoroquinolone absorption, and we sure do not want that. Take fluoroquinolones with a full glass of water to enhance absorption and decrease crystallurea. This class of antibiotics is teratogenic, so it should not be used in patients who are pregnant. Also, there's an FDA warning for tendonitis, tendon rupture, so make sure you educate your patients to report tendon pain or inflammation. Finally, our last flower, let's color it in red for side effects. S is for what again? You got it. S is for skin rash and sun sensitivity, so make sure to advise your patients to wear sunscreen. P is for prolongation of QTC and peripheral neuropathy. I is for increased risk of C. diff infection. N is for neurological issues such as confusion and insomnia. And finally, G is for GI upset, including nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. Alright guys, that's it for today. If you found this helpful, click that subscribe button for more. Let me know if you have questions in the comments and I will be happy to answer them. If you're interested in getting more information from our Top 200 Drugs Made Easy coloring book, I'll leave a link to the product below in the description, and I'll see you in the next video.